starting the show with Shai DeLuca-Tamasi, too. Give him a big round of applause. Hey, Shai. How are you? What a warm welcome. It's so nice. This is why I show up to work every day. Look at how happy they are.
They're amazing. We have the best audience.
They're the best. So here's with something that is not the best.
Not the best.
It is the corner fireplace. We get a question about it at least, I don't know, once a week.
At least.
Because people don't know what to do. So the corner fireplace, it's taking up way too much space.
Yes.
They don't know how to place their furniture because it's tricky. So we're going to show you the wrong way, and later on you will show us the right way to do it.
You got it. So, you know, the fireplace is such an integral part of our home. People buy homes based on the fact that there is a fireplace sometimes. I've been with clients that walk in and they're like, oh, fireplace. They don't care about anything else. They care about the fireplace.
It's true.
And it's such a challenge because what happens is that builders know that. So they're going to stick it wherever they can stick it. And sometimes they put it on an angle. Now, traditionally, the hearth was the home, the center of the home. We all congregated around there. So that was always the focal point.
Right.
It was always a focal point. Now we have our TV. This is a little guy, but imagine him a lot bigger. So big screen TVs, and people then, what they do is they put the TV up on top of the mantle, which we're now emphasizing this angle even more. And on top of that, we're talking about furniture placement.
Right.
So everything is looking towards this angle that sometimes we're trying to combat, or we're saying, I don't know how to work against it, let's say, for example. On top of that, let's look at the setup that we have here. So most people are, like I said, very comfortable for having everything looking at the fireplace because that seems to be the natural focal point in a space. Scale-wise, it's often the biggest thing in the room.
Yep.
So it's really a natural focal point. And because we're playing to it, we'll color a wall, for example, with a beautiful contrasting color. Now, this is a stunner. This is from Hearth Manor.
It's gorgeous.
So it's very hard for me to talk about the wrong way to do something with a beauty piece like this.
Yeah.
But we're talking about the corner. So it's really the angle we're looking at.
Yeah.
If this is a lighter mantle, the walls are colored darker. And then again, it's drawing our eye in. It's drawing our eye in. The way that we have the furniture placed on the angle looking towards it, it's making everything feel very, very claustrophobic, very
tight. It's very tight. And there's something about the angle. Everything looks a little bit off, right? Because the walls are going this way, the furniture is going this way.
Yes. Now, if you had a grand palatial home, which I do not, and you know, most people don't, this is okay because you know, you have the space to kind of space things out. But most of us don't have that space, so we have to be able to kind of work with it.
Right.
So we are going to talk about ways to do it in the next segment. But the first thing really is we have to get out of our minds that the fireplace has to be the primary focal point. So come over here for a second, hold my hand. We're going to have a little bit of a therapy session right here.
Let's do it. Let's talk it out.
Repeat after me. My fireplace
does not
need to be my primary focal point.
Oh,
that feels so much better.
It felt good.
Thank you.
That felt good.
So much better. Yeah, so we're going to talk about
Get rid of that notion, right?
And we're going to show you some ways to fool the eye, to trick the eye, and to work around it.
Okay, good. The therapy has begun.